Thank you, Karolina, for your patience.
That's fine.
Everyone, when typing your question, please use the name that's on your display. Name, affiliation, and language when you say, I have a question. We are ready to begin. Let us begin with Ben from the Times, followed by Mark from the Post, and then Peter. Ben, you are up to start the press conference.
Can you hear me?
Yes, yeah. When you see the green, that means you're on live.
Okay, I'm not sure if I can hear you, but hi, Karolina.
Hi.
I'm curious what it was like for you playing the first match on Ash, what you thought of the atmosphere on court and how it felt.
I felt better than in my match previous last week, what I've played on court 17. So definitely, I think the center court is better place to play, no matter, it's still without people, but I just felt somehow a little better. And I had a lot of practices on this court, so I just felt quite like used to it. And also just to play without people, I think that even I just had one match without people, but I thought it quite helped me just to know how it feels. And I mean, I still have my my team, and I felt just like on the center court, I think there's actually like a couple people. I mean, it's super huge and there still feels like super empty, but I feel there's at least like the player boxes, you know, where they stay. So I felt like there's at least a couple people watching there.
Mark, you're up next, followed by Peter. When you see the green box, you're live.
Yes, I don't know if you can hear me.
I can hear you.
Yes. Great. You mentioned a couple of people. I mean, it seemed like off and on there would be a player that would stroll into the stands and start watching. I mean, were there people, your friends coming in, player friends, or were you aware of who was actually in the audience? I mean, there's only, you know, a few, but...
No, actually, I try to don't really like look for people, but I know there's been couple around. I don't really know the names, but this is not something what I'm really like looking for. But I know there is players because most of the top players, which they get these lounges, they just stay in the lounge. So I know there's been people watching, of course, behind the cameras, millions of people, my family, my friends from home. So I know and I feel, I mean, much better, as I said, than I was feeling in my first match. And I think it's just about the experience of all of this, because everything is a little bit different, but the most time I spend here, the better I feel.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Mark. Peter, you're up.
Karolina, in addition to having no fans, there are a lot of other special elements to this tournament, including Hawkeye and towels and stuff. One of the things I'm curious about is the towel thing. Players have gotten very accustomed to being given your towels and having that taken care of for them. And psychologically, there's a whole process that has to be a little bit different. Can you just talk about that?
I mean, of course, I think it's quite smart to do all of these things. Of course, we are not used to it and feels maybe a little bit different, but I think it's nothing what we cannot really get used to it. It's more about like that you still have to think about it and you have to go and get your own towel. But I think it's nothing really... and maybe you know, like you think more if to take towel or not, because before you just showed and the towel came right away. So I think it's actually maybe in some point a little bit better. But I think it's smart because just it's less risky if, I mean, the less people touch the towels and I mean this everything, then the less risk there is that somebody's gonna get sick. So I think it's quite smart way to do it. And and then the players, they have to accept it.
It's not.
Sorry, I didn't hear you.
Did you have a follow-up, Peter? If you do, you can ask it.
Oh, yes. I'm not green, though, here, so. Okay.
I hear you now.
Yes, no, was it disruptive? Was it disruptive for you psychologically to make that change and think about that stuff?
No, I think it's not really about, you know, like getting those towels, because that's really like small thing. I think it's like combination of many things, which is a little bit different the last couple of weeks. But I'm sure I feel better now than I was feeling the first week of Cincinnati when I played my first match. I thought a little bit like weird on the court, especially here in New York. But now, since I've been here almost maybe 2 weeks, maybe a little more, then I'm feeling just better. And I mean, I thought I played good tennis. I'm not sure if I would play better with people or worse with people, but it's how it is. So I think we have to accept it.
Thank you.
Thank you, Peter. Courtney, apologies for the last press conference. We'll make it up for this one. You're on.
Hey, Karolina, how are you? Talk through that first set a little bit in terms of the 4-1 lead, letting it slip. And it seemed like, especially, what was that, in the 4-all game, I think it seemed like you were starting to lose your temper a little bit. But you were able to pull out of that and be able to save those break points and hold. And it seemed like you were very comfortable from there. But talk about just kind of the adjustments you had to make and how difficult that getting that first set was.
I think this match, especially the first set, was in a couple periods. I think I started, of course, not really great with the first game, but after I was able to somehow, step in the court and was playing quite aggressive, so I was doing a lot of points. I thought actually I played quite good till 4-1. Even after, I think I could still make, there were a couple close, calls and balls which I could make, so I think I could still go up to 5-2 at least. But somehow it was a little bit shaky there. I had a couple opportunities to go up, but I didn't. And then, of course, happened the first match. I was up 4-1. Then it was 4-all. So I start to maybe think a little bit too much. But, I think I just came up with some big serves on those 40-15 down. And I think I just felt much, much stronger after this game, which I made. And, the second set was much, much better.
And just in terms, match and everything, did you feel as though did you feel calmer now that you get this first match out of the way, you've gotten a win on North American soil? How much tension does this first round win kind of relieve?
No, I guess the tension is always going to be there no matter if it's first, second, third round, but it's different tension. I think once you win a couple matches, I feel like you can feel different, you can feel a little bit more calm, but of course you still want to win the next one, so I think the tension never really leaves, at least with me, but definitely at least I have the experience now just to win the match. Now it's my first match after a couple months, like official match, which I won, so I'm just going to try to build on that and continue in that.
And can you just talk about your next match against Caroline Garcia? What do you expect? It's not an easy second round.
No, for sure not easy. We played a couple times. I think she's a very good player, although she's not seeded now. I think she should be, or maybe in the future she's going to be. But very dangerous player, I think, especially on these fast courts. I think she can play good tennis. She can serve quite well, but nothing unbeatable. So I have to play well.
Thank you.
Any other questions in English? Courtney signed off. Mark, Peter, we good? I think we're good. Let us go to our friends from Native Language. Yaroslav, you are up.
Neslyším vás. Jenom vás vidím.
Okay, I don't hear anything. Mm-mm. No.
Tak to se omlouvá.
Jo, už to jde. Už to jde. Good.
Jo?
Jo, můžete.
Tak pardon, děkuju za trpělivost. Je to pro mě boj.
Pro mě taky.
Pro vás to nebyl takovej, teda byl to hladký. No. Jak to vypadalo, ten zápas, teda, protože vypadalo, že jste se potřebovala uvolnit trochu?
Jo, tak já myslím, že jsem začala jsem blbě, pak jsem hrála, si myslím, docela dobře ty 4 gemy, jak jsem se dostala nahoru, pak trošičku jakoby takový 2 gemy blbý, který jsem si myslím, že jsem mohla vyhrát a zbytečně jsem jako udělala tolik chyb a trošku jsem jakoby znervozněla, nebo ne, znervozněla, ona pak se trošičku chytila, takže. A samozřejmě první kolo vždycky takový nebezpečný tady v tom, takže jsem ráda, že ten game za těch 4-4 byl ohromně důležitý, takže jsem to tam nevzdala a nedala jsem žádnou lehkou chybu, naopak jsem zahrála skvěle. A potom už jsem se cítila hodně líp i v tom druhém setu a myslím si, že ona naopak jakoby potom byla psychicky dole, takže to bylo vidět a myslím si, že jsem tam měla potom pár dobrých výměn a úderů.
na ten zápas nemohou fanoušky nebo na ten turnaj, ale tím, že tam jsou ty skyboxy, tak to sledovalo ohromně moc tenistů. Vnímala jste to, že tam na vás kouká tolik lidí a jestli vy taky se budete dívat?
No, já se určitě budu dívat. A vnímala jsem to, já jsem se nesnažila úplně koukat, jako kdo se přesně dívá, protože myslím si, že nejsme zvyklí, samozřejmě vím, že většina lidí to sleduje, ale nejsme úplně zvyklí, že by se na nás jako chodil dívat někdo vyloženě takhle třeba jako z holek nebo i z kluku, takže jsem nekoukala moc okolo a snažila jsem se jakoby fakt koukat jenom na svoje lidi a maximálně jako kdybych tam potkala nějakou známou tvář, jako třeba ségru nebo holky z Prahy nějaký, ale jinak jsem nějak úplně nekontrolovala, kdo tam je a kdo tam není. Ale samozřejmě myslím si, že aspoň mě to trošičku pomohlo, že jsem věděla, že se tam někdo kouká, že to není úplně takový osamocený, jako to bylo třeba, co jsem hrála ten minulý zápas na té 17, tam to bylo takový jako hodně chcíplejší. Tady přece jenom jako už jenom ten centr, nějaká atmosféra, když tam ty lidi nejsou, tak mi přišlo, že tam byla.
Carol, you're up. Then we'll go back to Jaroslav. Carol, go ahead.
Ahoj Karolino, gratuluju k vítězství. Ty vždycky říkáš, že ráda hraješ na těch velkých kurtech. Zažila jsi někdy něco bizarnějšího, než hrát na největším stadionu na světě, který je vlastně jako skoro prázdný? Přišlo ti to divný?
No asi ne, ale jsem si jistá.
Připadalo mi to, že je to nezvyklý.
No asi jo, ale jsem si jistá, že jsem hrála už na spoustu velkých kurtech, kde samozřejmě asi tam nikdy nebylo tak málo lidí, jak teď, ale ne vždycky je plno, takže ne, že by se na to nedalo zvyknout, ale samozřejmě jako je to i tím, že nehrajou tam žádný ty, jakoby ta hudba moc tam není takový, fakt jakoby je to dost tichý, ale říkám, už jsem tady 2 týdny a už mi přijde, jsem si na to zvykla, na tom kurtě jsem trénovala spoustukrát teďka už na centru, takže mi to nepřišlo tak strašný, jako když jsem hrála fakt to první kolo a myslím si, že zvyknout se dá na všechno, nakonec jakoby furt je to zápas, samozřejmě lidi a nelidi je velký rozdíl, ale furt se musí hrát stejně, takže myslím si, že o to víc lidí, já to snažím brát trošku jinak, že o to víc lidí se prostě dívá za kamerama, vím, že jako z domova to spoustu lidí sledovalo, takže prostě tady na to se nemůže myslet, no.
Radek, you're up. When you see the green box, you're live. Thank you.
Výborně. Slyšíme se?
Jo. Je, dobrý.
Karolina, slyšíme se?
Mm-hmm, slyšíme se.
Blahopřeju postupu.
Díky.
Jseš podruhý na US Open jedničkou. Jaký to je letos? Už jsi na to zvyklejší?
Jo, tak letos tím, že ten rok je takový celý divný, tak mi to ani nepřijde opravdu. A jako tím, že jsem nějak půl roku, nebo vlastně skoro jsem odehrála asi 3 turnaje, takže nějak bych to úplně teďka, jako jindy mi to přijde taky jedno nějak to nasazení, ale teďka mi to přijde úplně jedno. A protože jsme viděli, jako i samozřejmě ten minulý týden a tak, takže spousta nasazených vypadlo a myslím si, že pár lidem to může trvat trošku, než se dostanou tam, kde jako by měli být a kde opravdu jako to nasazení je. Myslím, že v tom zápase byly záblesky, kdy bych mohla být první nasazená, byly tam záblesky, kdy bych mohla být třeba 50, takže tak nějak tam bylo trošku obojí. Ale jako tohle není nic, určitě se cítím o hodně líp, než jsem se cítila ten, co to bylo za rok, 2017, to jako to zase nedá srovnat.
Thank you everyone, thank you Karolina, thank you for your patience.
Thank you. Naschle.